Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh Pavade. I am associated with St. George's Medical College in KM Hospital, working in the capacity of Assistant Professor in Department of Biochemistry. Today, we are going to see steps of verification of Bayes' law. This exercise has to be performed after demonstration of colorimetry, spectrophotometry and automation in clinical biochemistry laboratory. So, we will go step by step. What are the specific learning objectives of performing this practical? As per the CBME, the competency 11.6 is covered under this session. The specific learning objective is, at the end of the session, phase 1 MBBS students shall be able to verify Bayes' law, explain relationship between absorbance and concentration, draw a graph representing relationship between concentration of light absorbing substance and corresponding optical density. What are the reagents required? We are performing verification of Bayes' law with the help of copper sulfate solution. We have taken 0.4 molar copper sulfate stock solution, the serial dilutions of which has to be performed, then a distilled water. Coming to procedure, you have to take small volumes of 0.4 molar copper sulfate solution, stock solution and distilled water in separate beakers on your table. Take six clean and dry test tubes and label them as TT1, TT2 up to TT6. TT1 is blank and TT6 is the purely stock solution. You have to use pipettes to prepare 6 standard dilutions according to the chart taking stock solutions. A chart is displayed in the next slide. Thoroughly mix each solution with a stirring rod. Clean and dry the stirring rod between uses, because otherwise the concentrations will be mixing up. This is the observation table which indicates you how the test tubes are labeled, in what volume you have to take stock solution of copper sulfate, how you need to add water and what will be the concentration, and in the same table you need to note down the optical densities after the practical, after the test tubes are ready for optical density measurement. So as you see, the number of test tubes is increasing, you see volume of copper sulfate increasing by 2 ml. And correspondingly, distilled water volume is going on decreasing. So, in the first, which we are labeling as blank, TT1, you see there is no copper sulfate added. We are taking 10 ml of distilled water. And the TT6, which will be purely stock solution, we are taking 10 ml of that and no distilled water is being added. So, the TT2, you see 2 ml of copper sulfate, 8 ml of distilled water. TT3 is 4 ml of copper sulfate and 6 ml of distilled water. So, like in the same fashion, we have tried to keep the total volume as 10 and we are increasing copper sulfate stock solution. In the concentration of copper sulfate is going on increasing as the number of test tube is increasing. So, the concentration is 0.00, 0.8, 0.08, 0.08, 0.16, 0.25, 0.32 and 0.40. So, correspondingly you have to measure the optical densities and note it down. After the test tubes are ready, prepare a blank by filling an empty cuvette 3/4 full with distilled water. Place the blank in the cuvette slot of the colorimeter and close the lid. This is zeroing of the colorimeter, water blanking the colorimeter. You have to select the filter of wavelength 635 nanometer. See, blanking of colorimeter has to be done for each wavelength. You can't do blanking once, and if you vary the wavelength, you have to zero it for the particular session of or a batch, right? So for the wavelength you have to zero it. So select the wavelength and then calibrate by pressing the zero button. So take cuvette with distilled water, place in cuvette slot, close the lid, otherwise the light from outside will interfere with the optical density or zeroing of the colorimeter. So close the lid, select filter of wavelength 635 nanometers of the colorimeter and then calibrate by pressing the zero or set button on the colorimeter. This will set your colorimeter to zero observance and 100% transmittance. And after that, take optical densities of all six test tubes. After taking optical densities, now you have to plot a graph. This is for verification of the Bayer's law. Take a graph paper, choose a proper scale so that your reading, your concentration are well accommodated in the given graph paper. And the scale has to be mentioned on right upper corner of the graph paper. Remember, take concentration on x-axis and optical density on y-axis. Plot the readings of all six test tubes taking their x and y coordinates precisely. The data points has to be encircled. Okay, and draw a line of base fit passing through origin. The line should pass through the origin and try to accommodate or maximum number of points should be on the line. So it will be a line of base fit. You cannot be drawing a zigzag line or do not bring those points on the line. First of all, plot the data points and then draw a line of base fit passing through the origin. What will be the conclusion? If the graph shows a linear relationship between concentration and the respective optical densities, the Bayer's law is verified. Okay, so thank you very much.